I just want to bring some encouragement to all of you. I've been on the social medias and it seems like there's a lot of people that are going through rough times. That's life. I love the quote, sometimes it be like that. The quote should actually be corrected and say, it should be corrected and say, all the time it be like that. There hasn't been one time, except when I was sleeping, where I didn't have some sort of stressor, some sort of situation that was rough in all kinds of ways. I also love the quote that says, in the end, everything's gonna be okay. If everything isn't okay, it's not the end. Don't stop, get it. Push, pray until something happens. So let me just bring you guys some encouragement and things like that. I saw this super cheesy meme, super cheesy post, and cheesy basically is it's maybe like not serious or it's like foolish looking. How do you define cheesy and corny? Corny and cheesy pretty much mean the same thing to me, where it's, oh man. Just look it up on the internet if you don't know what cheesy and corny means. But no, I saw this cheesy or corny post, meme, about people appreciating what they have. So first you had a person in a wheelchair looking out the window at someone who was walking. He's like, man, I wish I was there. Then you have the person that's walking outside looking at a person on a bike. The person's looking at the person on the bike. He's like, man, I wish I had a bike. The person on the bike now has been biking for years and months. He's looking at the person with the car. He's like, man, I wish I had a car, right? And then the person in the Honda Civic and the person in the car is looking at the Maserati that homie has. And he's like, wow, I wish I had a Maserati. Of course, the person in the Maserati is looking at the person with the helicopter. He's like, man, I wish I had a helicopter. Person in the helicopter is looking at the person with the airport. Man, wish I had an airport with multiple planes in it. So it seems like I know I have this situation as well. It's like you are where you are and you're always looking for better, always wanting to strive for the next best thing. Sometimes it appears the best thing for your happiness and your health is to just appreciate where you are. I say if anyone is struggling with where they are right now or feeling bad and downtrodden, just give to someone else. And I've done this multiple times when I'm feeling some type of way. It's like when you give of yourself to someone else, you just feel a lot better. You know, if I'm having a bad day, I need to make it my point to make someone else's day even better. So I know when I'm late for work, I gotta try so hard to be patient. So it's those days where I try to go out of my way to let people have the way. You know, I could be late. Maybe I'm late already, 5 minutes. But I will try to let that person go. Unless it's taking a long time, then I'm gonna go out. But otherwise, I'm gonna try to brighten someone else's day. Because life is too short to go through it all anxiety stricken, all sad, all depressed, all stressed. No need to be lying, dying, suffering, and crying. Gotta bring joy to the world. Joy to the world. You know what? Recently, I've had my own situations in life, you know? Got bills I gotta pay. Got situations in life. And I also have different ways that I like to deal with my things. Of course, a little meditation with some prayer is always good. You know, you can read, do some reading, read the Bible. Writing definitely helps. You write your things out. Whatever is going on in your mind, you just write it out. Also, this is kind of like a joke, kind of cheesy, kind of corny at the same time. But if you guys have a YouTube channel, or if you guys have access to YouTube, go ahead and search Bob Ross. He brings so much joy to my life. Just watch him calmly paint away. He's like, hey guys, today we're painting a nice scenery in nature. We're gonna paint some mountains. At the bottom of the screen, we'll have our different things. You know, titanium yellow. Titanium white, sorry. Got cadmium yellow. Got crimson red. We're gonna be painting with. You know, he has that calm voice and it just feels so good. I've been sending my fiance Katie these links like almost nonstop. Sugar, please forgive me, but it brings joy to my life. I want to bring joy to yours. All right. And then also the other one that I liked watching the videos that just brings a sense of calmness is Robert Rogers, or is it Fred? Fred Rogers. Not to be confused with Robert Rogers, Fred Rogers. He also has a bunch of YouTube videos online, and he just sings some songs when he's feeling some type of way. One of my favorite occasions on the Fred Rogers program, Mr. Rogers Neighborhood, is where he seemed to get angry, right? Mr. Speedy Delivery comes in there. He's like, hey, I need things quick. In life, people are always rushing you to get stuff done quick. Quick, I need it quick. And then Mr. Rogers, he kept a smiling face. He kept a positive disposition. But when Mr. Speedy Delivery left, you best believe Mr. Rogers went to his drawer. Let's see, where's my drawer? He went to his drawer, right? And he pulls out some Play-Doh. Play-Doh is like, I think it's flour, cornstarch, maybe not flour, cornstarch, maybe some salt, maybe some water, some soap, maybe. So he took out this Play-Doh stuff and he's like playing with it, right? He's like pounding it. So he's finding constructive ways to get rid of his anger and frustration. And I think many times we really don't have ways that we can get rid of our frustration besides exercise and maybe talking it out. I feel like talking it out or singing and exercising. Yes please. All right, so those are two guys I like watching. And there's also one more. I don't know how genuine Joel Osteen is. I don't know how genuine that guy is, but to me, just the alleged joy that he has when he does his sermons, it just brings a smile to my face. He's just like, hello brothers and sisters, I know you're going through some rough and difficult way of your life, but the Lord will use your trial and turn it to a triumph. He's going to use you as a victim and turn you into a victory. He's going to use your struggles and turn them into struggle in a good way. Amen. This is my Bible, I am what it says I am. I'll do whatever it says I will do. So those are the three guys that I like to watch. Fred Rogers from Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood. You also got Bob Ross with The Joys of Painting. You got Joe Osteen with his Lakewood Church. Amen. And his wife, Victoria. Alright, so if you guys enjoyed this video, go ahead and click that like button. Go ahead and comment in the section below. And go ahead and pray about it. Alright? All the time and be like that. So stay positive, try to have fun with life. We're here.